Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. You guys are doing fine? I hope so. Today's Bitcoin video comes with commentary, because why not? I feel like chatting a little with you while you watch my drawing process. So today's illustration is a redraw of a scene from Lego Ninjago. Whee! You know I'm obsessed with this show. I wanted to make a romantic illustration with a ninja for Valentine's Day, as it's become a bit of a tradition for me over the past years. But since I always have so much trouble coming up with ideas for this subject, drawing people interacting is hard, okay? And I'm also really hard on myself. I thought this year I'd take it easy, because drawing is supposed to be a joy, not a nightmare. I'm also experimenting with new tools and coloring style, as you'll see later. So I really wanted to take some pressure off my shoulders and focus on just getting comfortable using watercolor brushes instead of stressing about coming up with a super unique pose or perspective or dramatic lighting. You know, all that stuff that pros seem to be so good at naturally. By the way, did you know that you can see all of these experiments I make weeks before I post them if you join my Patreon? Oh my god, Rina, that was the smoothest self-promotion you've ever made. I know, right? Jokes aside though, it would mean the world to me if you checked out my Patreon and considered becoming a member. You can get lots of goodies like my Clip Studio paint brushes, chibi bases, exclusive tutorials, and obviously you'll always be the first to know about any new artwork I create, instead of having to wait weeks or even months until I post them on my public galleries. It's definitely worth it if you wanna learn more about what happens behind the scenes, or I guess in this case it would be behind the screens, huh? Rina, that was a terrible pun. Shut up, my sense of humor is a 10 out of 10. Anyway, let's get back to the drawing. I decided to pick this scene in which Cole, the black ninja, has just caught Jay, the blue one, in his arms to save him from the bad guys. It's a scene that I really like, and it also features my favorite characters, and I've been wanting to redraw it for a while. But then I thought, how could I make this more, you know, Valentine themed? And listen, I know these two are just best friends, canonically speaking, but in my head, they're 100% gay for each other. Just let me live my fantasy, okay? So I added my own little gay touch to this scene and turned it into one of those awfully cliché moments in which they both realize their feelings might not be as platonic as they initially thought. It was interesting trying to catch such a fleeting moment. I don't usually get to draw these kind of expressions, and it was a bit difficult at first because even just the slightest modification in the shape or angle of the eyebrows or the mouth can completely change the overall feel of the expressions and even the things that might be crossing their minds at that moment. I tried to clean the line art on this occasion because I felt like this way I could achieve a more organic feel, and I also just wanted to go for a less refined vibe overall. I'm quite square-minded, and I feel like I unconsciously limit myself when I start the line art in a new layer, because I can't help but stress about making super clean lines, and then the whole drawing loses a bit of the magic it had on the earliest stages. So I did try to be less strict about the lines. Not sure if I made it, but I did try. I'm also using a new brush for the line art, by the way. I made it myself while messing around with the tool settings. It has a pencil-like feel, but it also changes its opacity depending on the angle and pressure I put into it. I'm enjoying it so far. Might need to keep adjusting it a bit more, but it's a nice change from my usual clean line arts. Whenever I think it's ready, I'll make sure to put it up on Gumroad so you can download it too if you want to try it. After putting the base colors, I faced another dilemma. I didn't know if I wanted to go with a simpler approach, like using these kind of saturated colors that I usually use, or try to get a closer look to the original scene with all these blues and dark tones. And I guess I felt brave that day, so I went for the colder colors approach. And I'm glad I did, because it just makes a lot more sense. I mean, this was a redraw, and I wanted it to look similar to the original screenshot. But as I am not very familiar with this kind of ambience, preparing the lights and shadows was difficult. At first, I thought I could get away with it by making a multiply and an overlay layer on top of everything, but it felt like that would only bring me more trouble because it would be harder to control. So what I did was make another file with the drawing all merged up, and I started painting over it very messily, adding effects, using blending brushes like watercolors and stuff to get the colors and contrast right. Once I finished planning all that, I just saved the picture and color picked from it. That way I knew exactly which colors I had to use on the original file. I need to let go of my fear of choosing the wrong colors, but until then, this trick is really helpful as it allows me to mess around freely. We shall not be afraid of experimenting. That's the base of improvement, to fail and to learn from those mistakes. And from there, it was smooth sailing. Wish I could say that. But no, it wasn't all that smooth. But it was definitely interesting. I've gotten so used to using hard tools and color in a more cel-shading style that using watercolors now was difficult, but I did like it somehow. Being able to mix and blend colors and just go with the flow felt really good. I'm especially proud of the way I did Cole's hair here. I tried to focus on building up a 3D sense and depth to separate the different hair strands rather than making them super detailed and pretty. And it worked! If you have trouble drawing hair, you should check out my tutorial on that. I share several tricks and useful things to keep in mind to build up the structure with simple shapes and how to transform that into mind-blowing anime hair. I'll leave you the link up in the corner of the video. Don't forget to watch it later. And well, there's not much more I can say about the shading process. I used a mix of a dense watercolor tool and this other one that you can find on Clip Studio Paint Assets. I'll leave you the link in the description as well for easier access. They both work very nicely, although I still need to learn how to control them better. But I'm happy with the result. It wasn't nearly as disastrous as I thought it would be. So that was it for today. If you want to see more videos like this, with me talking about my art process, fun stories and struggles, come and join my Patreon! I'm having a lot of fun making new types of content over there, and your feedback is much appreciated. Don't forget you also get to unlock my brushes, chibi bases, high resolution pictures, and monthly features as well. Anyway, I'll let you enjoy the rest of the drawing now. I hope you have a nice Valentine's Day. Bye bye!